guys, welcome to another iPhoneNerd.com tutorial. Today we're going to be discussing how to preserve your baseband on iPhone 4 and upgrade it over to 4.2.1 and have it jailbroken at the same time. But this tutorial also works for people that are just trying to download a custom firmware bundle, like a pre-jailbroken firmware bundle, and want to restore it to it, but iTunes continues to give you errors. It works on a 3GS, 3G, whatever device that you might have. So first what we need to do is just download the tools, and we can go hop over right to iPhoneNerd.com and click on the download section. You do have to register in order to get to the download section, so make sure you register before you even attempt it. And right here in software, we're going to need to download RedsNose 0.96 RC8. If you have Mac, you download from Mac. If you have Windows, just select Windows in the download section. So you go ahead and download that. And if you have a Mac, you can go ahead and download Pwnage Tool 4.2, if that's what you please, so you can make your own custom firmware bundle. Alright, so once you got those two things, or just one of them, if you have Windows, it doesn't matter. If you don't have a Mac yourself and you need a custom firmware bundle that's already made to preserve your baseband so you can upgrade up to 4.2.1 and still have your unlock, then just go right into iPhone firmware, iPhone 4, custom firmware for the iPhone 4, and go into iPhone 4 4.2.1 custom firmware bundle, and you download that. This is already pre-jailbroken and is ready to unlock. If you already have an unlocked phone, then you have nothing to worry about when you restore it, when you get this. Okay, so we go right ahead and we download that, and once we have all those things, we should have all those things on the desktop somewhere, just so it can be easier. Once we have all those things, the first step that we want to do is we want to open up RedsNose. Right now, you're not going to be doing nothing special here. Just open up RedsNose, and you have to make sure that you have not the custom firmware bundle, but the original 4.2.1 firmware file for the for whatever phone you're using. So let's go back into iPhone Nerd, because I kind of forgot about that. Back in the download section, if you have an iPhone 4 or whichever phone you have, just select it. And right there, you click on iPhone 4, and here are the original regular ones. So you can go ahead and download iPhone 4 4.2.1. Boom, that's the regular one. So you need the regular one and the custom one. Both of these things need to be on your desktop. So once we've got the regular one, we're gonna go right into RedsNose. We're gonna browse, and we're just gonna select that regular one, and RedsNose's gonna do its thing. It's gonna say it identifies the ISPW. Let's just give it a second. Okay, it's identified it. We go ahead and we click next. It's gonna process the kernel, patch, blah blah blah. Just let it do its thing. Okay, so we want to uncheck everything. Different phones have different options. Just uncheck everything. And what you want to do is you just want to check just enter pawn DFU mode right now. Just enter pawn DFU mode right now. We go ahead, we click next. We got to make sure that our phone is off. So we shut our phone off and we go ahead and click next. We got to follow this. So boom. Hold the power button. Hold the home button. Just read this up. If you can't get it the first time, you can retry. Don't worry. But you need to get the phone to DFU mode. Once that's done, the software is going to tell you it's going to do it. Once you follow the steps, 1, 2, 3, just make sure you follow the steps. Once it does that, it's going to enter DFU mode, and it's going to say you can now restore with iTunes. So once that's done, I'm not doing it right now because I don't have my phone handy. Once that's done, we go ahead and hit cancel or finish, whatever it's going to say. It's going to say finish is done, and we just go right into iTunes. Let me plug my phone up here while that loads. We go right into iTunes, and let's just let it come up here. When it comes up, it's going to tell you that your phone is in restore mode. Let me unplug mine because mine is not in restore mode. Press that up. So once you Once you come on here, you should see your phone that it should be in restore mode. And what we want to do is we want to hit option. Hold the option key if you're on a Mac. Shift key if you are on a Windows PC. And click restore. And what it's going to do is going to pop up with the Finder. And what you want to do is just go into the custom firmware bundle that you downloaded from iPhoneWire.com. And select it and hit open. And it'll restore your phone. And you should get no errors. You should be jailbroken with a preserved baseband. Right off the bat. You can do this for the iPhone 3G. You can do this for the iPhone 3GS. If you just want to jailbreak it the easy way. You can do it this way if you're having problems with green poison, which has been giving me problems a lot. So just real neat and quick tutorial. Thank you guys for watching, and you guys have a very nice day. Today I don't feel like doing anything. Just wanna lay in my bed. Don't feel like picking up my phone, so leave a message at the tone. 'Cause today I swear I'm not doing anything. I'm gonna kick my feet up, then stare at the fan. Turn the TV on, throw my hand in my pants. Nobody's gonna tell me I can't. Nah, I'll be lounging on the couch, just chilling in my Snuggie. To MTV so they can teach me how to Dougie. 'Cause in my castle